People are whitewashing Nessa and is still a huge problem. Believe it or not, there's a huge problem with whitewashing Nessa, and it shouldn't be. This all started as soon as Nessa was shown at E3, and there was a huge wave of people drawing fan art and loving her and gushing over the new Water Queen, Nessa. But there were some who took the whole character being black to a new level. I'm in this group on Facebook called RWBY Republic, who has a lot of racist white kids who can't stand the thought of black characters. The first post I've seen on this is a drawing of Nessa by Sakimi-chan. Now, this picture isn't whitewashed per se, but it got a lot of people commenting on her post negatively, and it eventually ended up on the RWBY Republic group. I commented on the post, and I quote, "I think it's just the lighting, but I don't think that she whitewashed her. But it's been a problem with black characters," end quote. And oh my god, I got a shit ton of hate for that. There were a lot of fuckboys in the comments saying that black people have double standards and that since we make other characters black, they should be able to make black characters white. Which is a load of BS, by the way, and I'll explain that as we go on. But anyways, I'm defending my statement, and artists start drawing Eurocentric features on Nessa, like green eyes and brown hair. They're all drawing her white to prove there's a double standard, or just because they like it. And a few moments later, this post was made. Nessa as a fucking gorilla. It's racist, this whole post is racist, and you cannot defend this. Someone even made a mod to change Nessa completely whitewashed to, I don't know, troll people, but it's not funny. Whether you acknowledge this or not, America has a history that is, in fact, racist. Our media has just now started to include black characters in entertainment that aren't bad guys and aren't all thugs. We have been slowly represented in games and media, and we want to continue to grow. Segregation ended like 60 something years ago. There are still people alive today who fondly remember having their white only bars and fountains and restrooms. We have a history here. And I'm saying all of this to say we don't have many black characters to choose from. Take X-Men for example. There are 131 X-Men members. Can you guess how many of those characters are black? 6. There are 6 black characters in X-Men, and one of them was a rapper and a drug dealer on the side. And out of those 6, I bet you can only name one, right? Storm? It's always Storm. White people have plenty of characters to choose from, while we only have a select few. There's no variety for us, so it should be self-explanatory that some black artists draw their favorite characters as black. We want to see ourselves in these characters. Again, we don't have many to choose from, and the ones we do have are often stereotypical drug dealers, thugs, rappers, gangbanging, all that. Something Chris Rock said really resonated with me. We want opportunity. We want black actors to get the same opportunities as white actors. That's it. Not just once. Turning white characters black is not a double standard. Blackwashing is not a thing. The reason it's bad if a white person makes a black character white is because there's a history surrounding that you aren't accepting. People have been doing this for hundreds of years. Take Betty Boop or Katniss from Hunger Games or many, many more characters, for example, that were supposed to be black but were switched for white characters and actors. You want to know what a real double standard is? It's when a black cosplayer dresses up as an Asian anime character and people have a problem with it, but some white girl cosplays as the same character and doesn't hear shit. That's a double standard. Anime characters are Japanese at the end of the day, not white. You aren't acknowledging history and how black people would feel towards it. You call it fixing Nessa. Turning a character from black to white isn't fixing. And I don't care if you're trolling or not, I'm all for artistic interpretation, but when you do it explicitly to hurt others, then it becomes a problem. We have been slowly integrating our own characters in media, but there are still people who won't allow that, or opportunities aren't available to us because we're black or because we want black characters. the very least people can do after all the history of your ancestors and grandparents or even your parents is accept America's history and try to work hard to eliminate the issue, not deny it. It is a problem, and instead of trying to fix the issue, people make Nessa into a gorilla or make a white mod of her. African Americans only make up 17% of the US, so it's always been hard for us to make a huge difference, and our ancestors had to fight and die for it. It would be so much easier for everyone if the 77% of white people here would acknowledge racism and help remove it instead of making it worse and taking a game that has been inclusive for years and turning it into something disgusting. To summarize really fast, it's so stupid and ignorant that you take the one or two black characters that we have and make them white because you have so many characters to choose from. There's no point in doing it. The point is, if you're white, you can't tell black people what's racist and what's not racist, or what can offend us or not offend us. It's sad that we still have to deal with racist BS in 2020. Just stop being racist. That's all I gotta say about it. And just to get this out the way,
I'm black. I'm blackity black black. I'm the blackest black. I'm black.
If you like the art in the video, I have a print available on my Etsy, so go check it out if you want. If you like this video, please give us a like, share, and subscribe to our channel.